There are a number of parameters which need to be set in FactoryTrack for the system to be configured correctly. The first of these is in the administration submenu and is site parameters. This is where the system is configured to connect to the correct LN system and where key information is defined at the site level. In a cloud environment, this should have been set by cloud ops and shouldn't need to be changed. Elsewhere, under the parameters submenu, we have a number of different parameters we need to consider. First of these is global parameters. These are parameters that are used throughout FactoryTrack. We then have parameter group settings. These are where we have centralized parameters that are used throughout the system for key areas that are repeated elsewhere, such as the put away. We also have some time track parameters, shop floor parameters, and warehouse mobility parameters. These are global parameters that are set for the individual modules. Currently, time track parameters and warehouse mobility parameters do not exist, but if we're using the LN shop floor, then there are a number of parameters there which need to be set at the global level. We then have the transaction set maintenance. This is where parameters are set at a transaction level. Some of these parameters are at the transaction level and others will be at the order type level. This simply means that we can have separate parameters for different types of orders. In other words, if we use the allocate release for SFC production, we can have one set of rules. If we use it for sales, we can have a separate set of rules. Finally, we have warehouse parameters, which allows us to set individual parameters for a specific warehouse for a specific transaction. So if a transaction is supposed to behave in a different fashion in one warehouse to the others, then we would create the parameters for that or many transactions for that particular warehouse.